we wake, hear the birds and see the sun. Side by side our fears are done. Oh, the good times just begun. Oh, we know what we have, let's hold on tight. Found what we're looking for in life. Call us crazy, but things are finally right. With you and I, the future is bright.
Hello YouTube, this is Michael. I'm in Croatia. I just landed in Split and I just picked up a rental car. Croatia, it's a country a lot of my friends have been talking about. Many of them have been here on vacation before, and the first thing they always say about Croatia is how beautiful it is. So since this year I'm stuck in Europe, I thought maybe let's give it a try. And it is actually a big deal because Croatia is my 40th country I've ever visited. I know right now it's not the best time to come to visit Croatia for two reasons. One, we are in the middle of this second wave of COVID or third wave. I kind of lost count. So I'm not really sure what is operating and what's not. And the second reason is people typically come to Croatia for summer vacations. They come here to stay on a sailboat, party for a couple of days, do some island hopping, and you can't really do that in winter. So I thought, since I'm traveling solo, we might as well bring you onto this journey to show you the authentic Croatia in winter. So that being said, let's begin our journey. We are heading east into the mountains away from the coast, and I'm going to show you sort of a hidden gem in Croatia in the middle of the country. So without further ado, let's go. Okay, I'm gonna apologize in advance, but I'm gonna try to pronounce this place. So this place is called Vidikovec Polosko Blacho. This is actually sort of a rest stop, but the view is quite amazing, right? There's this huge lake over there. We're above it, and in front of it, it's a smaller one. Okay, so now it's a destination. I'm in a town called Imotski, near the Bosnia border, and it's famous for its blue and red lake. This one behind me is a blue lake. It's actually a gigantic sinkhole, and it's a karst lake. So what that means is it used to be a huge limestone cave, but over time, the ceiling of the limestone cave became thinner and thinner due to carbonation, and eventually it collapsed entirely, leaving this gigantic hole on the ground. So that's pretty impressive, right? And this one, the Blue Lake, is actually 220 meters in depth. And what's pretty cool about the Blue Lake is you can go all the way down to the water level. Let's go. And right now, I'm in a place called the Red Lake. Just like the Blue Lake, it's also a sinkhole. Even though dimension-wise, this one is a little bit smaller, but it's actually the third largest sinkhole in the world. So the cliff right there, from the top to the water level, is about 240 meters. But what you don't see is it also goes down by another around 300 meters. So that's pretty impressive, right? And right there are goats. I'm gonna try to zoom in and see whether we can find them. See? 1, 2, 3, 4 of them.
Alright, so a little bit of a side note. So to prepare for this trip, I also invested quite a bit into my gears. For instance, this one I'm filming on right now is my new Sony Alpha 6400 with a 8-inch 105mm lens and a Rode video micro for sound recording. And I also have my drone. So this is a DJI Mini 2. It looks a little bit different from DJI Mavic Mini. The remote control is different now. And I still have my old GoPro Hero 8 Black and the ND filter for the camera. So for all these gears, I'm also linking them in the description below, so feel free to check it out. And I really hope the video qualities of these vlogs will be much better. So please make sure you smash the like button and subscribe to this channel. And I'll see you next time.